and your children, teachers, and viewers across the globe. Yesterday, we talked about how to use certain verbs like open, read, write, and we learned how to make imperative sentences using those verbs. Today, I would like you to know how to use those verbs in their three forms. Now, look at the blackboard. Open, opened, open. These are called the three forms of the verb open. The second form is opened. The third form is called opened. In fact, the first form is called present tense. The second form is called past tense. The third form is called past participle. The first form is also called infinite. When ed form is there for the second form, ed form must also be there for the third form. So whenever you have ed form for the second form, you will automatically add ed form to the third form. In this way, open, opened, opened. Since the second form and the third form are ed forms, this verb is called a regular verb. Fortunately, there are many regular verbs in English. So, you should refer to a dictionary or a good grammar book and learn all the regular verbs on your own. You should remember that unless you learn them by heart in the beginning, you cannot write all the three forms correctly. Now, let us come to another point. You know that open is a verb and it is also a main verb and it is also a regular verb. Now, you should know something else. For example, look at the blackboard again. Open is the main verb. Open is the main verb here. In fact, open is a verb. But sometimes it is also acted as an adjective. Now look at here, openly. Sometimes it can be an adverb by adding the suffix ly to it, openly. Openly is an adverb. Sometimes open can be a noun by adding the suffix ness to it, openness. Openness is a noun. In the same way, it can be a noun by adding the suffix er, opener. Now let us know the meanings of these verbs. Yesterday, I taught you how to use the open in imperative sentence. Again, I am saying open the door, open the lock, open the window. These are called imperative sentences because we are using them to get things done by others. Now, let us know another example. Open can be an adjective. Let me see how it works. Today, our schools are open. That means our schools are not closed. Because of the coronavirus, these days schools are being closed. But sometimes on certain days, the schools are open. You should not say schools are open today. You should say schools are open. Because in the same way, you should say the door is open. Now that is the use of the adjective. Now come to the use of openly. Openly means publicly. Suppose somebody cursed you. You say, suppose somebody insulted. You say, David insulted me openly. Please tell, David insulted me openly. The teacher insulted me openly. That means the teacher insulted you in the class. You should say, know that openly is an adverb.
Of course, I will be teaching about the parts of speech later, but you should know how to use all these words in your sentences. Now come to here, openness. Openness is also a noun. It is an abstract noun. Of course, I will be teaching you all these things in our next videos. Openness is nothing but frankness. Suppose you like somebody's frankness, you say, I like David for his openness. That means, I like David for his frankness. Some people speak very frankly, so we like them. So we like the people who speak frankly. We like them for their frankness or openness. I am saying again, I like David for his openness, that is, for his frankness. Now come to the point, opener. Opener is an instrument to open a bottle like Coca-Cola. Suppose you went to a shop. There, you wanted to drink Coca-Cola. Now you ask, give me the opener. What will the shop wanna do? He will give you the opener. With the opener, you open the Coca-Cola bottle. So this is the way of making sentences on your own in your day-to-day conversations. Don't worry that speaking English is a difficult task. We learn things one by one. In this way, you can expand not only your vocabulary, you start speaking in day-to-day conversation. Grammar cannot be taught in isolation. When you teach verbs, we have to teach the parts of speech also. Anyhow, don't worry. I will be teaching you everything in detail so that you can be a good speaker and writer within 6 months. But don't neglect to follow my lessons. Please follow them regularly and like them, and don't forget to subscribe to them. This is JVN Narasimha Rao signing off for today. I will be meeting you in the tomorrow morning. Bye. This is JVN Narasimha Rao signing off.